Welcome everybody to One Spot Gaming. Today I'm going to show you how to play the best tank in the game, aka Fernando, Nando, whatever you call him. Let me start with cards or loadout which you should use for the Fernando apart from that basic loadout. So the first card which I will recommend is that while shield is active, that's last stance card. It's the best card for Fernando, I think, and that makes Fernando all this tutorial is based on this card, I think so. And the next one is reduce ammo cost. If you want to go like there are so many Fernandos, but some of them prefer to do damage. Then you have other cards. I will say you can choose any of these cards, but this one is really great as well. Safe travel when you're on low HP and you don't have your shield as well, then go for the charge and you will get your shield, a little shield back up. So that's all about the loadout of Fernando. Let's jump ahead and let me tell you guys which cards you should pick up for the Fernando at the start of the game. The first card every Fernando will suggest you is the Gasterize or Catalyze card, which reduces the healing effect on your enemies. It's really great because you are mostly dealing with the point or objective where there are tanks and healers grouped up over there. So it will be really best to reduce their healing as far as possible, because your damage can do more damage or more damage per second, whatever you call it. The next card will be the Cronus, because of our loadout, which contains a card which heals us when our shield is up and we are below 50% of our health. That's the last stand card, which is my loadout name, and it will be really handy if you have shield up whenever you are about to die as Fernando. It will keep you in the battle and help your team as well by shielding them from the enemies. The best tip or most important tip I want to give you guys is that don't die too quickly while at start of every game. Just make sure you go there, don't use your shield fast, like wait till you are below, like about 25% health. Not too low, because there are chances that enemies might be behind you, their flanks might come. Then use your shield and keep using the shield until you get to 50% health, and then use your fireball if you see those enemies are in the bulk. Fireball is really great ability to use. I really like that ability for Fernando. I many times killed some Grogos with that ability as well, because they were at low health. Using fireball really affects enemies. It's effect which, you know, you can get more damage when it hits the more enemies. Like I hit like 4 enemies and got damage up to 1000 damage for just a single player. It was really great. I will definitely recommend you use fireball as often as you can when you are on not so low health. As we have started talking about abilities, second ability, or apart from shield, you guys know how to use shield. I just explained to you that you should wait till you are at low health and then use the shield to get your health back up due to our loadout. The next ability I will focus on is the charge ability, which helps you to stay in the battle longer, as well as due to our loadout, we get some shield when I'm at really low health and don't have a shield to use. I will definitely go for charge and get some little shield on me, stay in the battle and won't die that easily. It also helps sometimes to escape Torvald's ultimate. Yeah, his ultimate is so annoying, as well as many ultimates can be avoided using charge alone. Like Drogo's ult, he's coming at you straight. You can avoid his ult from using charge alone. For avoiding ults, I will suggest you guys to use your ultimate to avoid most of the ults out there. All the ults can be avoided, and you can save your team as well from enemies ult. Like I will say, some of the deadliest ults are Sky's ult. You can pretty much use it and the team won't die. No call the creep for Sky. Then there are so many ults like BK's ult. Most important one is Drogo's, maybe. I will say that he's so annoying for Fernando when he's using his ult. And there are so many ults which can be avoided, like Ruckus. The list goes on. Pretty much every ult can be avoided. It is really great if you have your healer using his ultimate when you are using your ultimate, because at that point your health will be low and he can heal you or pretty much everyone in your team, so that at least you won't die when your ult is over. So to summarize it up guys, here it goes like this. Don't use your shield quickly, use it when you are on low health. Save your team and yourself from others' ultimates by using your own ultimate. Use fireballs such that enemy teams will get so much damage, like it will hit most of them. Use your charge ability to escape from battle or save yourself. That's it guys, these are the key points you should remember. I tried to get to master using my Fernando, but you know, I reached up till I think 4300, but then got down, just lost one match, and then got down up to 4100. That's really bad. Thank you guys for watching and keep shielding your team.